There have been some truly amazing breakthroughs in the tech industry over the last few years. But let's be honest, there have been some times where brands have introduced products or technology and we've had a strong sense of deja vu. You know that feeling that our teachers had when seeing our homework? Oh, come on. We've all done it. Copied someone's homework just before class. At least, I'm gonna admit to doing it. Now, if you're also gonna admit to it, leave a comment down below. It's kind of funny when we did it as kids, but it's not exactly funny when multi-million or multi-billion dollar brands kind of do it today. So in this video, we're going to be taking a look at 10 times smartphone brands ripped ideas off other smartphone brands. Hey guys, Ash here from C4E Tech, and if you do end up finding this video fresh, turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon. Let's now get started. Do you remember the LG Stylo? Nope. Okay, I'm not gonna blame you for it because the Stylo was not really something worth remembering because it was not really a success. Come to think of it, not much that LG has done in the last few years has been a success. But hey, different video for a different time. But now back to the Stylo. The phone was inspired by the Galaxy Note. Now to be clear, LG isn't the only one who's gone about stealing or copying, borrowing, you know, the stylus idea. We have many other such examples, the Moto G stylus being the most recent. Unfortunately, all these phones, they were just using basic capacitive styluses. Styli? I don't know, what's the actual plural? Okay, anyways, that just mimics the finger's touch and not a digitizer and stylus combo that Samsung's used on their Notes. Samsung themselves even tried this kind of a capacitive stylus with the Galaxy S3 and a C Pen. Man, did that bomb. If anybody remembers the C Pen, leave a comment down below. So none of these matched up to the S Pen, that kind of user experience, you know, in looks, in functionality, nothing really matched up. I've been using the Note 20 Ultra as my primary, and I have to say the S Pen, it most definitely is something uniquely Samsung. I'm gonna miss it when I move on to my next phone. By the way, something that's not unique to Samsung though, is that Note name. Many brands have tried to run their own Note series. Some like Xiaomi have found a lot of success doing it. None of them though are really Notes. Yes, they do have large screens, they are phablets, but come on, you guys get what I'm saying, right? These two are nowhere near the same price. Heck, the Redmi Note 9, for example, or any Redmi Note for that matter, they don't have a stylus. But that did not stop Redmi or Meizu or Coolpad or Honor or Panasonic or I can't recall any other brand. But you know, it didn't stop all of them from trying out their own variant of a Note, their own take on a Note. It's not just the Note though, in fact, it seems like the smartphone industry as a whole, they've had troubles with names. I mean, take an example of the Sony Xperia 1 2. But hey, when brands aren't coming up with mind-boggling names for their phones, they're usually copying others. In most cases, Apple. With the iPhone 6 Plus, Apple entered the arena of large phones and Android OEMs got a new name for their phablet-sized devices. In came a barrage of Redmis and later on Nokias with Plus tagged on. Till then they were doing Primes and suddenly they all switched to Pluses. Then Apple returned with a Pro and boom, we got the K20 Pro, the OnePlus 7 Pro and so many other Pros. Now that we've got the Ultra lineup from Samsung, I'm sure we're gonna see a bunch of manufacturers tag an Ultra to the back of their devices. The Mi 10 and the K30 Ultras are just the beginning. Now we move on to something truly amazing. Remember all the leaks about Apple's full Sapphire displays? That never really materialized. We got an Apple Watch out of it though. In the meantime, Huawei went one step further by preempting Apple, beating them to the market with a Sapphire glass touring SNP 7. I guess Apple must have felt like the friend who we copied from, but both of us did end up with different answers. Like, how does that even happen? In a similar vein, a lot of companies started including notches after the iPhone X. Credit to Samsung though, they did stick with their own design language. I mean, they did come up with Infinity V and Infinity U, which were notches, but they did call it Infinite. Okay, let's not go there. Anyways, if all these companies copying from Apple made you think Apple's the leader and never the follower, nah, Apple are not about it. Let me show you something. This is iOS 14. It's got widgets, it's got an app drawer. Well, sort of, you get the point. Anyway, this isn't the first time either. There have been prior instances like iOS getting features like Raised Quake from Android. And of course, the aforementioned large size plus, that was just Apple reacting to all the large screen phones that Android was doing. And honestly, I'm not against any of this because like for example, with operating systems, when they pick up features, be it through innovation or call it borrowing, it's us, the end users, who benefit. And I know they aren't, but hey, Apple, if you're watching, can you guys please, for the love of God, copy T9 dialing from Android? Pretty please. The software train goes the other way around as well. After all, once we had gestures on the iPhone 10, suddenly all Android OEMs were running to implement that on their phones. Now, to be fair, some of them had their own unique take on it, but the one that's become the most common, the one that Google themselves have implemented, it's very similar to iOS. Swipe from the side for back, swipe from bottom for home, swipe and hold for recents. Once more, I think this is actually great because it helps lessen the learning curve for users switching between iOS and Android, and that's always a good thing. Sometimes though, Android brands take this a little too far. You know, they end up putting things like control centers on their phones. That was kind of jarring. But even these brands have been toning it down in recent times. Now, coming back to the hardware side of things, let's talk AirPods. At launch, people laughed at the AirPods. Many mocked Apple for having the courage to get rid of the headphone jack. Fast forward a generation, and these were the same people who were removing headphone jacks from their own devices. The Pixel lineup, OnePlus, Sony, and in recent times, even Samsung has ditched the headphone jack in their flagship lineup. Why? Well, officially the reason is they lack the space. But think about this for a minute. Every brand that ditched the headphone jack now magically has a pair of TWS earphones to sell, and they'll launch a new pair with every new flagship, just like Apple did with the AirPods. Now, these brands, they saw how well the AirPods were selling. They noticed that apart from just selling new phones, they can also make a little bit more profits by removing the headphone jack and selling TWS. So bye-bye went the headphone jack. The AirPods design has also been heavily borrowed by some brands. Till the AirPod launch, TWS earphones look like this. After the AirPods launch, TWS earphones, they look like this. Of course, there have been exceptions, especially with brands like Samsung, but most brands have been happy to follow Apple. And it's not just with earphones, it's also with the Apple Watch. It's the best-selling premium wearable out there, so it stands to reason that a lot of companies, including Oppo and Xiaomi, have tried to emulate that design. That being said, Apple Watches are special not because of the hardware. Actually, it's mostly the software, and sadly, not a lot of Android smartwatches have been able to replicate that. Wrapping it up, we have one more instance of Apple's design being borrowed. We are kind of starting to see a trend here, aren't we? This time it's the MacBook Air. A lot of budget ultrabooks, especially from the Apple of China, you know, they seek to emulate the MacBook Air design philosophy. Once more, this isn't one that particularly irks me since the Air does have great construction and it's quite lightweight. So if there's one laptop to be inspired by, the MacBook Air is a pretty good place to start. And hey, I've never used macOS, so I love a Windows version of it. Of course, since this is C4 Tech, we must have a bonus pick, right? And this one is more software based, but this time it involves an app. So Snapchat started the Stories feature. And now there isn't a social media platform that does not have a Stories feature. What started off on Snapchat is now an integral part of Instagram, WhatsApp, Facebook, YouTube, and even Twitter has its version of Stories called fleet.
No! God, please, no! No!
So what we've seen so far, this is not an exhaustive list by any means. I'm pretty sure there are more instances where tech companies have ripped each other off. So let me know if there is any other major one that I missed in the comments below. And if there is something that's really irked you, let me know in the comments. And I will possibly try to do a part two of this. And with that, we kind of get to the end of this video. Thumbs up, thumbs down based on whatever you felt about it. And if you want to see other fresh videos like this, again, let me know in the comments below. Thanks a lot for your time. Thanks a lot for watching. Subscribe if you haven't yet. And if you've already subscribed, turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon. Until next time, my name's Ash. You've been watching C4 Retech and I'm signing off for now. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.